Hello students, in this video we will talk about a new poem, A Prayer for My Daughter. This poem has been written by W.B. Yeats. Let's learn something about the poet first. Born in Dublin in 1865, Yeats' lifespan is divided almost equally between the 19th and 20th century. He was born of Protestant parents. His father, John Butler, was a painter. Yeats received his early education in London, but later shifted to Dublin, where he studied art for about 3 years. He did not receive formal education at a university and regretted this throughout his life. He founded the Irish Society in 1891 and was responsible some years later for the Irish Literary Theatre. He concentrated on ancient songs and legends of Ireland. He was elected to the Senate of the Irish Free State. He was given the Nobel Prize for Literature in 1923. He was married in 1917. Yeats' works may be divided into 4 phases, corresponding to which we have the 4 stages in the development of his poetic style. Yeats started writing in the tradition of the Pre-Raphaelites, and the poetry of this phase has a dreamlike atmosphere and the style is highly ornamental. The Lake Isle of Innisfree belongs to this period. After his marriage started the period of his interest in theosophy, physical phenomena and mysticism in general. He developed his own private symbolisms. The mysticism of the East also attracted him. The final phase of Yeats' career was marked by a return to the passionate life. He began writing poems as cold and passionate as the dawn, and his last phase was marked by a greater austerity in style and a greater precision in the use of language. His plays, like The Countess Kathleen, The King's Threshold and Deirdre, are famous. Yeats is well known for his The Wild Swans at Cool, Michael Roberts and the Dancer, The Tar, The Winding Star. His earliest verse, The Wanderings of Orison, employed the Irish legend. His other famous works are The Wind Among the Reeds in 1899, In the Seven Woods 1903, The Green Helmet 1910, Responsibilities in 1914, A Vision 1925, and Last Poems 1939. Let's learn something about this poem. This poem was written in 1919, a few weeks after the birth of Yeats's eldest child, a girl. The poet had purchased the old tower or castle at Thur Ballyhale, renovated it and settled there soon after his marriage. This castle forms the background to this prayer, which runs into 80 lines, divided into 10 stanzas of 8 lines each. The poem expresses the poet's solicitude for his infant daughter. Professor Jasbir Jain writes, "This is a tender lyric expressive of the poet's concern for his young daughter Anne, born in 1919, when the First World War had just got over." The poem is marked by a strong protective attitude and a prayer for a balanced life of happiness for the young child. There is uncertainty and an instability in the world outside. The future appears to be equally uncertain. In these circumstances, the poet prays that may the gifts of God be such as to endow the young child with qualities which would win her friend and happiness. The poet is in a gloomy mood, partly through his grave concern at the turbulence in society and partly through anxiety for the future of the child in a world which is growing harsher and coarser every day. The poem is a manifesto of Yeats's personal ideals in old age of settled life with a home and established status. The word ceremony is a key word in Eats and in the books of Coetzee.